All right, guys, welcome to, I'm going to teach you guys my best 6 setups to trade Nadex. Going to go over some educational material, and I'm going to give you guys a trade at the end of the webinar, so stick around, because literally one of the cool things about the product I'm going to talk about, you can have an account funded by the end of the night and have a trade placed, because I'm going to place a trade going into the overnight session on what I'm talking about today. So stick around, because you can be doing this by tomorrow, which is awesome. But anyways, going to take a couple of guesses out here. I want to start off this presentation. Some of you may know this if you've seen it before. But so I had started trading Nadex. If anybody here ever actually heard of Nadex or binary options in general, or are you guys primarily options traders? Couple of yeses. Cool. Trade it now. Awesome. Fabulous. So a couple of no's though. So if you've never heard of it, you're going to like this even more. And now you have. All right, guys. So in 2015, I decided to look into a binary product called Nadex. Now, Nadex is the North American Derivatives Exchange, Nadex for short. But I decided to test this product out using the trading strategies that I have. And at the beginning of December, it was right around like December 12th, 13th, I just threw $250 in a trading account, and I said, well, let me just see what I can do with this. My initial goal was to turn that $250 into $2,000 by the end of the year, which I thought was pretty achievable. I ended up far surpassing that goal, and I'm going to ask for a couple of guesses out here. What do you think I was able to turn in 13 days flat, I was able to turn $250 into? So just a couple of guesses out there. And Ashra, seems like you've seen it's a 16, 50, 25,000. Not very good at it. All right, 16,000. Yeah, so just over 16,000 is the answer. I actually turned $250 into over $16,000. And part of the reason why that was is I actually didn't miss a single trade during that time period. But I consider myself a professional trader, and I've been doing this for a while. And my skill level is pretty high. But knowing that I could do that, turn $250 into $16,000, that's when I said, nah, this just went from an experiment to a repertoire and a tool to mess with my trade and add to my tool book. So I've been trading Nadex ever since, and I'm going to show you guys the setups I used to turn that $250 into $16,000 so you can get trading them tomorrow, and then I'm going to give you a trade to take that I'll be on tomorrow. So it'll have to set up tomorrow. If it sets up, I'm going to be nailing it. I gave one out in a presentation last night, and I absolutely nailed the low within less than 2 points in the ES futures for a 10-point trade. So you're going to want to stick around, because we're in a really good market for what I have set up. Anyways, keep going here. First risk disclaimer. You guys can read this while I talk about this, but the risk is so important. Obviously, no representation is being made that the use of the strategy or any system the trading methodology will generate profits. Past performance is not necessarily indicative of future results. There is substantial risk of loss associated with trading securities and options on equities. Obviously, if you guys are traders, trading's risky. You can lose money trading. It's important to know that. And I just have to disclaim that so nobody sues me, right? Don't end up like the Wolf of Wall Street. Anyways, guys, this is me and Tom Sosnoff. If any of you guys ever heard of the program called Thinkorswim? Love Toss. All right. Any of you guys know who that guy is in the bottom right-hand side of the page? Tom, you got it. So anyway, couple of years back, that's actually when I first got into trading education. When I was 22 years old, I taught on Tom's show, Tasty Trade, which is the largest internet audience out of any options education firm out there, which is pretty cool, the $700 million man. I studied under him, mentored under him, taught with him, have a good relationship with him to this day. But that's what got me started in education and really got me exposed to this world, because I've always been a trader before that. On the left-hand side, it's just me at a prop desk, at a prop trading desk with my friend. You don't need that many screens to trade, but when in this case, I took that picture in 2015. I was trading, anywhere from 20 to 30 different equities a day, using level 2 quotes, so, you know, needed a few more screens than the average folk. But a little bit more about me, guys. I bought my first stock at 15. Some of you wonder, well, the hell did you do that? Were your parents into it? The answer is no, I was into it. I used to read Forbes 500, and I was like, what are these people doing to make so much money? And I would read through page after page, billionaire after billionaire, and the continuous theme was these guys either made their money in hedge funds, investing, or generally just speaking, they had, you know, stocks. So, you know, Larry Page, all his money was tied up to Google, or, you know, if it's Warren Buffett, Berkshire Hathaway. What I realized is that the stock market was the quickest way to make $1 billion. Now, I am far away from $1 billion, but I do think I will get close within my lifetime. We'll see. I actually think I'll hit 100 million at one point, but $1 billion, I don't know if I want to work that hard. But anyway, that's when I first started investing. I learned my first trading lesson at 18, funding an account with $1,000 with options. Now, that guy before me made options trading look really, really easy. I'll tell you what, I've traded options, and I actually think it's the hardest product I've ever traded. I trade futures, binary, and traditional options, not so much traditional options anymore, but I've literally traded every asset class, and I would say options is probably the hardest one for me personally. I started an account with $1,000, ran it up to $5,000, thought I was a genius, ended up losing all of that money, and my first trading lesson at the age of 18, you know, trading is risky, and you don't know what you're doing until you study really, really hard. So, the age of 20, I actually got an opportunity to study under a hedge fund trader, where I learned a lot of the technical analysis strategies, emotional management that I use today in my trading room, got my first job at a prop firm at 22, did a class with Tom Sosnoff, and then I discovered the power of binary options in 2015, just going into the end of the year, where I took $250 into $16,000 in 13 days. Then I took a vacation with my lovely girlfriend in Naples to kick off 2016. So I actually recorded all of those trades. So some of you are probably curious, well, you know, hey, like everybody comes on here and says they're a great trader, right? I mean, that's, you know, everyone does it on these presentations. But the cool part is I actually recorded every single one of those trades, and I talked about why I took the trade, how I managed the risk on the trade, my goals on the trade, et cetera. Really break down the trade, because, you know, it's easy to just talk about winners and losers, but it's hard to actually put them on and record them and explain yourself. So I've actually recorded all those for you guys, and I can get you access to those. Anyways, little graph of my P&L, astronomical. I was very happy with myself, surprised myself actually, and I continue to trade today and pay all my credit card bills out of my Nadex account that I started with $250, which is awesome because I feel like it's like free money at this point. So what I'm about to teach you guys is how binary options work. What exactly are binary options? The one trade I used the other morning, and with that trade, so if any of you guys do have full-time jobs, obviously you can't look at the market all day. Nobody's got time for that unless you do finally reach the point where you're a professional trader and are paying your mortgage, house bills, etc., your wife's alimony, whatever it is. You know, you gotta wait to that point. So there needs to be certain setups till you get to that point that you can trade along the way, whether it's after hours trading, which I did a little bit of last night. And yeah, so this is just a little screenshot of a trade I hit a couple weeks ago, last time I did this presentation. But I continue to trade Nadex to this day. But how many of you guys out there consider yourself technical analysts, like your focus is on predicting price movement and just determining support and resistance level setups? Like how many of you guys consider yourself that? Or if you're just a premium seller that's, you know, going off of, you know, historical volatility versus high volatility, basically what you do? Technical analysts. I mean, if you guys are indicator guys too, you know, a lot of people use indicators. I don't use any indicators, but so a couple of technical analysis out there, newbie, no worries. I was a newbie once too, and everyone told me I'd never make it, but now I'm laughing at them. So the perfect product for a technical analyst is a binary option, and I like to say it's options simplified. I personally think options are extremely complicated, traditional options, because there is so many mathematical factors. I guarantee you 95% of options traders could not name them or compute them on the fly. So I like to focus on a product that I understand more directly, and that is binary options. We're going to go over why binary options are a lot better than traditional options and how it really just simplifies the trading of price action. I like to call what I did the reverse blowout. Many people start accounts with large amounts of money and take it to very little, especially if they're options traders. That's just my experience with people who have come to me. They've said, hey, I started with X amount and you know, I'm down to very little or nothing. I said, well, you know what? We got to help you out with that because that's not a good place to be. I've personally taken – the last time I traded options heavily was in 2013, and I took a six-figure loss a month after I had my first six-figure gain, and at that point in time, I said maybe this isn't the product for me to trade, and I started focusing on futures. So that's just kind of my background on futures, options, Nadex, and what I know about trading. Let's get into the meat of it here. This is what you guys want to do. Get out your pen and paper. We're going to go over how Nadex is going to work and how you can profit from it. So Nadex binary options are limited risk contracts based on a simple yes or no market proposition like will the markets go up at the end of the week. Now I'd like to just take a poll. How many of you guys trade the S&P futures? ES, whatever, or you just look at the SPY? Okay, a bunch of yeses here. Okay, now if any of you were to guess, what's the trend right now? Are we in a bullish trend or are we in a bearish trend? Okay, I see all bulls right now, which I would agree with. If anybody said bear, I would ask you to question your technical analysis. So anyway, yeah, I believe we're in a bull trend, and so this is the difference between a Nadex contract and an S&P contract. Does anybody know what the market maker move is on the SPY going out into tomorrow? The expected move? I could look it up real quick. I was just curious if anybody knew it off the top of their head. I don't really trade traditional options anymore. But I just kind of want to show you what the difference would be. So the expected move tomorrow, let's see here, is $1.16. So that's in the SPY. So the expected move in the SPY is $1.16. So technically speaking, you would need a $1.16 move to return 100%. Give yourself 100% return, roughly speaking, in a traditional option if you just wanted to buy SPY calls. Where did I get that? I got that from Thinkorswim data. So the expected move is $1.16 tomorrow. With a Nadex binary strike, all you need is the product to expire above the strike price. I don't need it to expire $1.16 above. It can be 16 cents above, it can be 6 above, it can be 600 above. It doesn't matter. It's a binary level. You're either going to be above or below the strike you choose, and that's as simple as you put it. That is simply how you place the trade. Everyone understand how that works? So binary options are going to offer traders a way to trade the most active stock indices, commodities, Forex, event, and Bitcoin markets with relatively low collateral. Like I said, I started an account with $250. If you want to day trade options, traditional options, you need 25 grand. If you want to day trade stocks, 25,000. Not everybody's got 25,000 to throw down an account. Now, if you fund an Nadex account, like I did with $250, that is all you need to day trade. Literally all you need, and you can fund it with a debit card, which is kind of funny. But binary options are cash-settled contracts that settle with an all-or-nothing payout left till expiration. So if the contract is achieved, the settlement value is 100. If the contract condition is not achieved, the settlement value is 0. Okay, it is possible to also close a contract prior to the expiration to either take profits or cut losses. Similar to a traditional option, obviously you can trade in and out of the product. With traditional options, you're limited to 3 day trades on a 5-day rolling period. There's no limitation, no pattern day trading rule associated with Nadex, so you're allowed to be a little more active in the markets without having the $25,000 threshold in your account? Frank, the answer would be yes. So let's look at this. So this is what a Nadex order ticket will look like. We've all placed trades before. Maybe some of you have not. But it's literally, this will pop up. This is called an order ticket. And I'll explain what you see in this order ticket. When I took this screenshot, the S&P was trading 1947. The strike price was 1947, and the S&Ps are actually trading 1948.3. So just slightly above that level. In this instance, I would be buying if I were to assume or plan on us trading above 1947 at the end of the expiration, which in this case is 4:15. 4:15, you know, the futures close Eastern Standard Time. The offer is $60. I would be paying $60 to make 40. The index is already trading above this strike. So literally, as long as it went sideways, it could even go down a little bit, I would be profiting from this position. However, if we were in a bearish condition at the time and I thought we were going to sell off and go further, I would actually only risk $45.50 to make $54.50. So it goes both ways. Once you determine that, hey, this is a support level, we're going to either hold the rally from here, I will traditionally buy the closest Nadex strike associated with that. And these are the kinds of setups that really just allowed me to turn such a little amount of money into a large amount of money. Now, I've gotten lucky with traditional options before. And, you know, to me, that's the only way to turn a little into a lot. It's just kind of getting lucky in options. It's like sooner or later, if you put number, you know, if you're playing roulette and you're playing the numbers and you're playing 23, sooner or later you're going to hit 23. But, you know, for this, they're all calculated moves. You're not just getting lucky. Let's go to the next slide here. So why trade Nadex? For any of you who have never traded Nadex, I hope you have accounts by the end of this presentation. I'll show you how to set that up. But there's a few benefits of trading Nadex binary options. Limited risk, guys. The maximum amount of money you can lose on every trade is your original investment. Any other leveraged product you're trading traditionally, like if you're going short options, if you're selling naked calls, if you're trading futures, or if you're shorting a stock, you could technically lose more money than you have in your brokerage account. Does anybody remember KBIO, that guy who shorted like $12,000 worth of the stock and ended up owing E-Trade 120 grand? I mean, that was just a few months ago. Although those events are rare, they do happen, and safe to say that that will never happen in a limited risk contract such as Nadex. Also, low collateral required. Binary contracts are priced between a 0 and 100. So, like I said, you can start an account with small amounts of money. For me, Nadex began as an experiment just to see, hey, can I figure this out? I have setups in the S&P 500. I've defined my setups. What if I just apply them to Nadex? So it literally started out for me as, hey, maybe I can, you know, maybe this will work. I wasn't really that positive on how it worked. And then I just applied the technical analysis and the setups I know, which I'm going to teach you today, and had tremendous results. In fact, the highest percentage gain I've ever had in a month I did last year when I first started my Nadex account. So I still have not replicated that percentage return, but obviously it gets harder as you scale up. So short-term contracts, binary expirations are going to range from 20 minutes to 1 week. If you're going to trade a traditional option, you got a couple of choices. You got the weeklies and you got the monthlies. That's it. Weeklies, monthlies. You don't really have any other options. Now, with the Nadex binary contract, I got every 20 minutes and then every hour at the end of every day and at the end of every week. So now I'm getting to choose what strike I want to trade rather than the exchange say, hey, we like this strike. Every week, it makes this easy for our systems. We're only going to give you a few. Pick which one you want. Nadex allows you to really take more control of your trade because you're determining the time and their expiration. The market is not, okay? So that's another cool thing about Nadex. But my favorite part about binary options is you know when you enter a contract what your max profit is and what your max loss will be based on where the price is. Now, I saw there was a lot of options traders in here. I want to know how many of those options traders have you ever placed a trade on an option? The price has gone your direction. You sit in the trade. You think it's going to keep going. Then it stalls out. And then all of a sudden, you are eating theta. and the contract, even though the market's not going against you, that contract is worth less and less and less and less and less and less until it is exactly what you paid for, even though you were right on the movement. How many of you guys has that ever happened to? Too many times. Too many times. And I'll tell you what, I mean, I'm speaking from experience, guys. When I stopped trading traditional options, I lost $100,000 in a day. And I was like 23. That shit sucks, all right? Excuse my French, but that is something I never wanted to experience again. And the fact of the overnight risk, the theta, all the calculations, I realized that maybe these sophisticated computer programs that are front-running my orders and trading, you know, Delta Hedging Gene strategy, selling these options, are more sophisticated than me. And maybe my really true advantage is only my technical strategies. And if my true advantage is my technical expertise, what's the best product to trade? The answer is Nadex, right? Binary options. Price is king. I teach price action. I'm a price action trader. I'm a pattern trader. I'm a setup trader. I'm a real trader, all right, guys? I don't do this for fun. Binary options are the best product for price action traders. If you find yourself wanting to be a price action trader, wanting to learn to find setups, or you already have them, this is your go-to. They do have 5-minute binary options. However, that to me, 5-minute binary options, you might as well be gambling, because I don't believe over that short a period of time you really have an edge, maybe with other strategies, but I prefer at least an hour out. But that is a good question, Arturo. They do have 5-minute binary options. I choose not to trade those. I think that's gambling. So what is the cost commission structure with Nadex? And you guys ever like took a look at your option statement or your stock statement at the end of the year and be like, wow, I spent that much money on commissions? So Nadex cost commission structure, this is how it works. 1 to 10 lots are going to be 90 cents per lot, and then it's going to get capped at $9. That is an awesome benefit as you scale up. Lots 11 and above have no additional fees, so as you begin to trade more and more contracts, your cost per trade is actually going to go down as a percentage term, because you're going to get capped at $9 per trade. If I want to buy 100 lot and say I'm with Thinkorswim and I'm paying $1.50 a contract, all of a sudden it cost me $150 to put on that trade. Lots 11 and above have no additional fees. All right, so that's really, really cool. Expiration times are given in Eastern Standard Time, and spreads on the contracts are usually $3 to $6. Now spreads are where market makers are going to have their edge, and you know that's how they make money. Traditionally, just like any other options contract, market makers are making the money by just cashing it on the edge and then delta hedging their positions. Same thing with Nadex. Now there's going to be no high frequency traders. I don't know if any of you guys have ever, you know, been trading an option. You're looking at the bid, you're looking at the offer, you see an offer posted of 40 contracts, you go to buy 40 contracts, and all of a sudden you get filled on 15 and the price moves up. Has that ever happened to anybody? Happened to me. One of the cool things about Nadex, there's no HFT. You're not going to get front run, have to move up your bids. All the orders and offers placed are real, which cannot be said about traditional markets. Can you do verticals on Nadex? Yes, you can structure them in a way to do verticals. I see another comment in here that says, don't buy options. Sell deep out of the money options. You will do great. I'm sure you will do great if you sell deep out of the money options, but the problem is, you will probably be subjective to minimal returns, and the capital requirements to sell deep out of the money options are significant compared to Nadex. Now, I could never start a account with $250 and sell calls and expect to make $16,000 in 3 weeks. I mean, that's just not realistic. I couldn't even make a dollar, because they would never let me sell a contract with that. So it's like, you know, going back to the whole, if you've never done this, it's really just, I never did it when I first started, and I had so much success that now I'm teaching it. So once again, guys, this is one of my favorite quotes by a guy named Bernard Baruch. If a speculator is correct half of the time, he is hitting a good average. Even being right 3 or 4 times out of 10 should yield the person a fortune if he has a sense to cut his losses quickly on the ventures where he is wrong. Now, they always say, you know, the market goes two ways, up or down, so technically a monkey could be right half the time, right? I mean, it should be that easy, right? If the market only goes two ways, why is trading so hard? Well, the thing that makes options different is you don't need to manage the exit like you would a standard position. When you're trading, whether it's stocks, options, or futures, what you're looking for and what you're constantly thinking about is what is the ideal exit? How much, what, you know, is do I let my option run? Do I take it from a 30% winner to 100%, 100% to 300%? How greedy are you going to be? I always thought that having that as, you know, okay, in my head I'm thinking, where do I exit, where do I exit, where do I exit? When I'm constantly thinking about the perfect exit, it takes away from what I need to focus on, which is the price action and just staying above support and resistance. So I actually like that the profit is capped in Nadex, because I don't have to think about managing the position on the exit and timing it so perfectly where I'm getting the most amount of reward on my risk, because that is all clearly defined on the entry. Four things a person needs to be able to compute when trading traditional options: the delta, gamma, theta, vega, volatility versus historical volatility. Now, the professional options traders I know are very sophisticated in math and the Black-Scholes module, which nobody really teaches except at the professional level of options trading. Now, that is some super sophisticated stuff. I'm really good at reading charts. I think that is also probably the easiest skill to teach, chart reading, when done correctly. I'm not necessarily good at doing six different formulas of math at the same time while placing a trading decision. So I'm not going to go ahead and focus on that. I'm going to focus on my strengths. I had a mentor early in my life that always says, you know, don't try to fix your weaknesses. Spend 20% of your time on your weaknesses, trying to make them better, but 80% on your strengths. And my strengths are chart reading. So that's why I focus on this product, and that's why I've done incredible with this product. So what I'm going to show you here is a charge trade. This is, we're going to want to get out a pen and paper and write this down, and then I'm going to give you guys a trading setup that I'm going to take. You'll be able to fund your account, you know, by the end of the night, because you can do it, and then place a trade tomorrow. And if you take the trade, you can come back and thank me. I'll give you my email. All right, guys, so this is a trade that's going to occur when market is either trending up or trending down. This is a very clearly defined trading setup. You'll be able to use it in your toolbox come tomorrow. So what we're going to look for is we're going to look for a gap, number one. On days market is gapping up or down, doesn't matter. Then we're going to look for 3 15-minute bars that go green or red. So open, market opens, we gap up, we sell off 1, 2, 3, boom, that's all you need to know. After the first 45 minutes of the day, you're going to know this setup will occur or will not occur, because that's the exact criteria. Once that setup has happened, you're going to look for a 50% retracement. How many of you guys use Fibs? Fibonacci's, ever heard of a 50% retracement? Perfect. Ashra, you seem to have it down. Roger, you got them too. So if you've never heard of a Fib, you're going to want to pay attention. So this is that setup here, guys. Very clearly defined. You have a gap up. 1, 2, 3, 15-minute bars to the downside, all red. You want to make sure they're all in the same direction. Then what I'm looking for, and this is one of the trades I use to take $250 into 16 grand, what I'm looking for is a 50% retracement, and that is my entry. That is my, it's that simple. So this is a criteria. You have a trigger, and then you have an entry, right? This is the trigger that tells you I'm going to take this trade, and then that is the entry. In this case, I bought the 1932 strike. So what I'll do with Nadex is I will find the closest strike to my entry and try to get in for $50. I'm risking one to make one. What I'll do then is I'll buy strikes that are 2 hours out, 1 to 2 hours out, depending on the expiration. So if this trade traded at 10:15, I bought the 11 o'clock strike, and then I also bought the end of the day strike. Okay, so that produced 100% return in the course of a few hours. Now, I don't need the market to sell off from 1933 all the way down to 1880. I mean, that was a 50-point move this day, but usually the setup does have a lot of continuations in it, so sometimes I'll be even more aggressive with my expirations going out for new lows or new highs. Same setup to the long side. Gap up, 1, 2, 3, 15-minute closes to the upside. You get your 50% retracement back. In this case, I bought the 1904 strike, betting that it would be above in 2 hours, and at the end of the day, cashed on both those positions. Same setup in the Russell. gap down, 1, 2, 3 strikes down, okay, 3 50-minute bars down, you get your 50% retracement pullback, 10-12. Now this, I ended up buying a 10-11 strike, betting that we were going to be below that, coming 2 hours, and at the end of the day, and I cashed out on both of those positions. Your contracts are settled at close, the money is immediately deposited in your account and available for trading instantly, which is awesome. You don't have to wait T+1. If you don't have a margin account when trading options, you have to wait a couple of days for the money to settle. You can't get back in and out. Greatest thing about Nadex, you don't have to worry about getting your money to rotate back over into your account. You can instantly adjust your position and take a trade. So what I'll do is, this is the important thing with those trades, guys, is when you get that 50%, does everyone understand how this trade works? Or does anyone have any questions on this trade before I go a little further? Does anyone have any questions on this trade? Okay. So you guys should be able to use that trade. So what I'll do is, there was a gentleman who said, hey, well, what about 5-minute buying areas? I think when you go down to the smaller time frames, it really just becomes more of a gamble. When you give yourself an out, I take no shorter than 45 minutes, so I'll go 45 minutes to 2 hours on one strike, and then I'll buy the other strike at the end of the day at 4:15. So anything less than 45 minutes, I just feel like, you know, I'm not giving enough time to manage the position. That trade will set up about once every 10 days, but I have 5 other ones, so I'm getting one to set up pretty much every day. So traditionally why traders fail is they'll trade products they don't understand. They don't know the exact max risk and the exact max reward, which creates psychological confusion. A lot of traders, I mean me, when I first started trading, I traded a product I didn't understand, and you know, because I had a product that was linear in its upside, I was always holding on to positions too long, not exiting correctly. I love the time exit because all I got to be right is on the support or the resistance. I don't have to be right on the distance it travels. I don't have to be right on any of that. I just have to be right on the initial entry, which I think a lot of traders are. How many of you guys are like really good at like entering positions, but your exits kind of need some work? Like you feel like you got the entry down, but the exits are just, yeah, not there yet. Yeah, so I mean, this is the type of trading that you want to be doing. Also, a lot of traders use lagging momentum indicators. I am not an indicator guy whatsoever. I don't believe you need them. Every single trader I know that makes over $10 million a year trading for their personal account actually just trades price action. Now, I only know 2 traders that make that much, but none of them use indicators. React to price. And a lot of traders, when they first start trading, they react to price. They don't plan their trades. And a lot of traders, they either chase up or chase down. Who is guilty of chasing here? Who's guilty of chasing? Me. I see it. No worries, guys. I was really guilty of chasing. Now, in 2009, when I first started trading options, chasing was okay because the market was going straight up. But we have a different market. 2013, chasing was okay because the market was going straight up. You can't be chasing in this type of a market. You really got to know your setups. So lacking tactical skills, chasing, reacting to price rather than planning a trade, all of these things you see on my screen right now are probably some of the reasons, if you haven't found any success, you could relate to. And I related to a lot of these before I found my momentum, my rhythm to begin trading. I mean, I'm only 26 years old. You know, and if I'm doing this for a living, there's pretty much no reason anybody else can. I mean, I don't consider myself an extremely intelligent individual when it comes to school, but I'm just very adaptive and very risk-defying when it comes to trading. So any of you guys got like a stack of books like this in your room or your house laying around? What's the smallest amount you can trade? You can start with $100 with Nadex. Yeah. twice that many. I got twice that many too. Books never really taught me how to trade. They inspired me. Definitely learned a little bit of psychology if anybody ever read any Mark Douglas, but I've read every single book you're seeing there. But I'm a visual learner, and I'm assuming most of you guys are visual learners. Otherwise, you wouldn't be here. I think the most valuable thing you can get from a trader is watching him trade live. Have any of you guys ever been in a trading room where you were able to watch a trader execute not just some of his orders where he, like, you know, shows his winners, but actually execute the trades live? And how many of you have not seen that happen? Because that is what taught me. That is what taught me to trade, was watching a live trader trade live. So the four steps to trading success for me, and this is my advice to you guys. You want to trade a product with max risk and max reward known at your entry. This is going to eliminate psychological mistakes by reducing the complexity of your actions, right? Then you need to define setups that occur every day of trading. Do any of you guys have defined setups? I have a piece of paper on my desk with six defined setups, the setups I teach, that I just keep on my desk. Now, I know them all by heart, but it doesn't hurt to have it printed out. It's like a graph. It's like a cheat sheet when you take a test. You know, a couple of notes here. I define them all just like I showed you guys here today, and then I print them out so I know what they look like, so I don't catch myself jumping in a trade just reacting to price rather than actually planning it out and executing based on what I've clearly defined to be my edge. Live trades are rare with gurus. I agree, Zoltan, but I'm different. So execute trades based on setups and price and ignore the noise of indicators. It's another one of my advices to you guys. Ignore the noise of indicators. Focus on setups and price. So what I got here is I have a brand new course, my six best setups to trade Nadex. The same setups I use to turn $250 into $16,000, right? You're going to get lifetime access to this course. You're going to get access to my glossary. You're going to learn how to use my Fibonacci sequences. But what I want to show you before all of that is I want to just give away a trade, okay? And I'm going to pull up my chart here because I'm going to be taking this trade tomorrow. So I trade live in my room every day in front of my students, which is, like I heard before, it's pretty rare that somebody does that in this industry. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give you guys a trade I'm going to take. I'm going to be buying at any point tomorrow. Now, the Nadex strikes haven't come out for tomorrow yet because the market hasn't opened, but I am going to look for a 50% retracement from the high of Tuesday, and this is the setup I teach, so this is an extra one. From the high of Tuesday to the high of today, I'm going to look for that 50% retracement, which is a 2070. If we trade down to 2070s, I will end up buying the 2074 to 2072 Nadex strikes. So you'll be able to fund your account and take this trade by the end of the night to get into Nadex for those of you who want to. But for those of you who want to learn the rest of my trading setups, I have a course, and what you're going to get my course, and for $7 extra, you're going to be able to watch me trade live for a month in my room. And this is a lifetime access course, guys. It's not like, hey, you know, you pay it and you pay it again and you pay it again. This course is going to be $97 for the first 50 traders that sign up on demand immediately. You're going to get your login, mltnadex.com. Roxanne, all of the links for opening Nadex and all of that stuff has gone over in my course. So you're going to go to mltnadex.com. You're going to learn. What I do is I trade obviously live every day in my room. I'll record the trades I take. I then database my analysis as well as the setup that I've taught you and apply it, record it, and then add it to the course every single week. There's five different setups I did not teach you guys today. I taught you guys one. There's a halfway back, the bully, the dive, the leg start, and the flunk. You guys are going to get this piece of paper when you sign up. Of course, if you can print it out, if you don't got a printer, go to the library. It's like a cheat sheet for my trades. It's what I keep on my desk all day long. And these are the six setups that I was able to achieve a 5,000% return in 13 days. So that's pretty incredible. I don't know if you guys have ever seen somebody do a 5,000% return in 15 days and record every trade. I've seen people talk about it. I've never seen it all recorded. I do have it all recorded. To sign up for this course, guys, mltnadex.com. It's going to be $97. This course is normally $197. So then you're going to get my trade grids, which is $200. The lifetime membership access value is $2,000. So literally, this is a $2,400 course value for $97. Here today only, available to the first 50 people. Whoever signs up is going to get this. MLTNadex.com, guys. And if there's any questions regarding the course, regarding the setup I used today to teach you guys, if you want me to go over that again, or regarding if you guys want to see the video where I turned $250 into $16,000, which was awesome because I literally just took that money and went on vacation, which is kind of nice. Brent, I can talk about the setup. So what you're going to want to do, Brent, can you show tomorrow's trade again? Tomorrow's trade is when we trade down into 2070. I'm going to buy the 2072 to 2074 Nadex strikes in the ES. Do you have a phone number that you give out? Yeah, we do have a company number, and you can text it. Obviously, it's not my cell phone number, but it's 323-786-2575. And then support email, it's going to be a call. But I'm not going to buy it. I'm going to wait till we trade in 2070. 2070 needs a trade. Is that a long call for tomorrow above those strikes? Yes, it's a long call for tomorrow above those strikes. Now, obviously, I'm just giving you guys one day's worth of trades, but if you sign up for MLT Nadex and you want 30 days worth of trades, you're going to need to join my room. Like I said, in 13 days, I took $250 into $16,000. So we'll see what you guys learned in 30 days of trading with me. If anybody has any questions, support@majorleaguetrading.com. I will send that in here, support@majorleaguetrading.com. What's your last 13 days been like? Well, I made $4,000 today. The day before that, I made $7,000. I think Monday I lost $2,000. So, I mean, it's been pretty good. How much is my room? It's $7 for 30 days, and after that, it's $99 a month, but you can cancel it anytime. So, I mean, honestly, just to come in and watch for 30 days, you guys will get an absolute incredible amount of value from that, just watching me trade all day, every day. In theory, you should be able to do that every month. No, you actually can't do it every month because you're limited. So the Nadex contracts are going to be only 200. So I actually wipe out offers now. My normal Nadex contract size is 200. I wipe out offers and bids. So, I mean, my size is as big as the market can take. When that trade I gave you guys today sets up, I will wipe out the entire offer. My trades happen all the time. I mean, last night, I took the trade I took last night. I'll show you guys a trade I took last night. I made, what was it, I made like, this is one I made $4,000 on. It was actually, so I mean, sometimes when I'm bored, like at night, like, I mean, I don't like watching TV, so occasionally I'll just trade. But this is the setup I took last night. Similar to the halfway back I went over, but you have a 50% retracement to target, and then this one goes to target, and then all I did was pull this when waited for that 50% retracement, and this is the move I caught last night, and I put on the trade literally while I was watching the Hawks game, and I woke up this morning and cashed it. Just a 50% retracement from the low to high. You got to know when to draw them. You can't just draw blindly 50% retracements and expect to make money. Nadex is 24 hours, but you can also do at the end of the week. You can do, you know, hour out, etc. But, you know, if you guys want to learn more, you're going to see I have thousands of dollars in trade profits. I mean, tens of thousands in this MLT Nadex video. They're all live trades. I record them. I document them. I show you them. And then I implement them. A lot of people just talk about strategy. Not a lot of people take the strategy and then make money live. You know, it's easy to teach. It's harder to, you know, actually execute. I do both. All right, guys, if there's no more questions, I think I'll get Reed back on time.
Jack, if you are all finished up, I can take it back from you, my friend. You do have an extra 3 minutes, but I can definitely take it back from you, and we can end it there then.
Yeah, if there's no more questions, I mean, you know, I'll get you back on time. When does the course start? It starts instantly. The promo code, you go to mltnadex.com. I guess I could answer these questions, but it's $97 one time. And then you guys, for an extra $7, can join the room. So it's $97 for one time for the course. You get that for life. And then if you want to join the room, it's an extra $7 for 30 days. The $97 is one time, all video recorded. And there's, like I said, I got this like cheat sheet, I call it, where it's just a picture of all the setups and when they occur and the in them defined like I gave you guys today. So it's a nice little cheat sheet, and honestly, for $97, it's the best deal on any course I offer. I do not know what the Cantor exchange is. Is it hard to figure out? I don't think it's hard to figure out at all. I think it's actually probably one of the more simpler platforms. And this course starts, I mean, it's an instant access course. So as soon as you purchase it, mltnadex.com, check your spam and promotions folder if you have a Gmail. Spam and promotions folder, and you will be sent all that information. Your login, you can go in, start watching. I'll see you guys in the trade room tomorrow. Show me the cheat sheet, please. I cannot. It's in my hand. You want me to take a picture and text it to you? If you want to see the cheat sheet, unfortunately, you're going to have to pay up. Sorry, but not everything I do is free. That's the good stuff, and so, you know, there's a premium for it. What time did the room open? 8 o'clock. Yeah, give that guy an A for effort, right? See you in the room. Awesome. Through that, Frank, through that, when I did that 250 to 216K, I actually didn't lose on a single trade. I know that sounds hard to believe, but I didn't lose on a single trade. I literally recorded them all. Now, I obviously do lose on trades. Like, there's no such thing as a trader who doesn't lose, and that's not my claim by any means. I just had a really, really good streak. Yes, Ed. How many losers in a row did you ever have for the year? I don't think I've ever had more than 3 in a row. But I'm not, you know, obviously that was just really just an experiment. I mean, when I start with $250, I'm not really concerned about losing $250. So I decided to press it into the end of the year and then just write myself a check and go on vacation. That's all I did. But, you know, I trade a little different now. My account's a lot bigger. And I'm not going to be going all in. Plus, I mean, I'm wiping out bids and offers, so I'm limited on my size to about 10,000 to trade. Are there days you don't trade the market? In Nadex, there's days I don't trade the market, but I'll trade futures all day long, every day. And there's also days I don't trade the market, and I'm usually doing things such as golfing, fishing, enjoying my time, hitting the spa, etc. And that usually happens around 10:30 on a Friday. But that's the life of a trader. Exactly, regarding. So I'm going to wait till we pull back into 2070, and then I'm going to put the trade on. Not too many. I don't want too many of you guys putting that trade on, because you're gonna mess up my offers. Where do you access Nadex? You go to mltunadex.com. You purchase a course, we'll send you all the information you need. Once you sign up for the course, you get all the information you need, guys. I mean, there's literally everything will be in there. So all the questions you have that are not getting answered, I have in video format. I go over it, setting up an account, where to go, trade setups, how to place a trade, how to enter trade, how to place a trade on a demo. It's all there, guys. It's a go-to resource. You have access for the life. If you don't take this deal, I'm very disappointed and surprised, because this is the best, cheapest deal you're going to get all day long, hands down. MLTNadex.com. Are the trades similar to options like spreads? They are similar. It's something you're going to want to, you're going to go 300 contracts. It's something you're going to want to just demo just for a day, just to get the hang of it, because once you get the hang of it, then you're ready to shoot. Awesome. How long is the course? Well, it's getting longer and longer by the week, because what I'm doing is I'm continuously adding to the course. So that's a cool thing. Once you're in on the course, it's always getting updated and you can always learn more. So, you know, as I take trades, I don't record every trade I do, because sometimes I got a lot of things going on. I don't have the time to sit down and record the trade. But I record every week, add it to the course, show my material, show the setup, you know, and just continue to educate you guys. Your order is not going through. Please email support@majorleaguetrading.com if that's happening. support@majorleaguetrading.com. You traded Nadex but didn't do so well? Well, Brent, you probably didn't have defined setups. And you also probably didn't trade under a professional, which always will help. So I hope I can help you, and I look forward to seeing you in my room. So like I said, guys, once you purchase a course, check your spam and promotions folder, as well as, you know, it'll say, do you want to join my room? Just click yes. Awesome, Quentin. Thanks, Regarden. Appreciate it. Thank you, guys, and I look forward to seeing you guys in my room. Hope you guys learn a ton from me. I'm fairly young making this happen. There's no reason why anybody else who's driven enough to make it happen shouldn't be able to do it.